What is the universe? The universe is a window where we can visually set up our exact room layout with lasers and zones placed as they are at the show. It also allows us to quickly select zones and to see what is playing and where. You can even add custom controls to the universe. It definitely makes multi-projector live show control and programming much faster and easier. Using a second monitor. To reduce the amount of windows and information on your main Beyond screen, I recommend using a second monitor for the universe, the preview window, and for a second workspace. We will have a look at this dual monitor configuration a bit later. Before we open the universe, there are a few things that we need to do. Setting up projectors and zones for the universe. What we normally do is we take our FB3s and we label them on the top with a few bits of information that will be helpful throughout the whole programming or show process or setup process. We like to take the serial number of the FB3 and stick it right on the top of the unit, which is really easy for reference. Next, we like to put a piece of masking tape or some other sticker on the unit that you can just write on which projector that FB3 belongs to. What we normally do is we have a dedicated FB3 for each projector. This is a permanent dedication. We think it's a good idea to have one FB3 for every laser projector. So not only does it allow independent control, but it also gives us the benefit that it will retain the setup settings for that projector and FB3 combination. So items such as color in the setup, and scan rate and so on, those will be recognized every time you plug that FB3 back into the Beyond software. The next thing that we do at the show site is set up our projector settings. Let's go here to Settings, Projector Settings. We select the projectors that we want to set up. Just for the universe demo, I'm going to set up two different projectors. Doesn't really matter which ones here, we'll just do it for test. We reduce the size of the X and Y and move it up top just for safety reasons. And then we can put on a test pattern and set up our color settings. So we're happy with that. And then adjust our scan rate and color and blanking shifts. That's usually about all we need to set up each time. And then we go back to size and position. And we're going to make it 100% on the X and Y again. That'll give us maximum flexibility later on. The other important thing is to make sure that each projector is set up straight out, so no mirroring or inverts. So we want to have them set up all straight out. And I'll show you why a bit later once we're in the universe. Now that we have our projector set up, the next thing that would be good to do is go down to the bottom of the screen here, and the two projectors that we're going to use, we're going to actually label them. So if you right-click on that projector, we can rename it. So let's just call this left one. And we'll call this one next to it right one. Now we're going to open up the projection zones. So here we have our projection zones, and what we're going to do is we're going to assign the projectors to the zones. So let's make a zone called left one. We'll take the first zone here. We'll create one called left one. And we'll move it up the list. And then we'll take this one here, we'll create a new one, we'll call it right one, and move it up the list. So now we have left one and right one. Now we have to assign our projectors to it. So let's go on this one here, and we'll select the projector that we called left one. And for right one, we'll assign the projector. Right one. Now, all the rest, the other zones that remain there that we will not be using at a particular event, what we want to do is we actually want to either mute them, usually mute them, or you could even delete them if you're not using them. So we're going to go ahead and mute the zones that we're not using. So we'll select them and just press the mute button. This way there's no chance of any accidental output going to zones that have not been set up. So it's very important. Next, we're going to go over to the BAM, the beam attenuation map. And I just wanted to explain one thing quickly. We recently did a show and there was a video projector set up just over front of house. And as we know, lasers and video projectors do not mix too well. So it's very important to mask out an area. And some people, rather than masking out an area, they might choose to scan under or over the video projector, but you're kind of sacrificing the show by restricting your zones like that. So what we normally do is we paint or we black out an area right around where the video projector is. And usually the video projector will be centered in the room. So if you paint an area or black out an area right around that projector, you still have the entire area all around it for the laser effects. And actually, you don't even really notice or see that that area is painted out because it remains symmetrical. As I mentioned, the video projector is usually centered. Now we're going to set up our preview window. So we'll go over to the preview tab. And in the case of graphics, well, you would set it up view as laser graphics. In the case of audience scanning beams, what we'll do is we'll select that and we'll go over to the ERP. And we're actually physically going to set up the position of this projector. So this one's called right one. So let's move it over to the right. Where did that say 35? Down here, 35. Here. So now we've moved that projector over to the right. Next, we'll go over to the one on the left. And we'll do the opposite and move it the same amount to the left. So we could go minus 35 and minus 35. There. So if we want to preview how both of them look, we can just select the outputs here and switch back and forth, and we can see